class we are going to discuss of solubility of gases in liquid. Students, in the previous one we have discussed of solubility of solids in liquids. There we had discussed the main points. First, like dissolves like. Second, we had discussed why ionic compounds are more soluble in polar solvents. Then we had discussed about the dynamic equilibrium between the saturated solution and the undissolved solute. Then we had discussed the fourth point. We had discussed about the some terms. What do we mean by solubility, saturated solution, and then we had discussed supersaturated, unsaturated solutions. And then fifth, we had discussed that how these factors were various factors were affecting the dissolution of solids in liquids. Now here in this class, we are going to discuss about the dissolution of gases. First, let's revise the meaning of solubility. The amount of solute that can be dissolved in 100 grams of solvent at a definite temperature, at a defined temperature. Now, solubility of gas in a liquid. What are the various factors which are going to affect this dissolution? See, students, the first factor, it is the nature of the solute. Nature of the solute, that is the gas. Nature of the gas. The gases which are easily liquefiable, they can be easily dissolved in the gas. In the liquids. Second, nature of the solvent. Nature of the solvent or the liquid in which this gas is going to dissolve, how it is going to affect? See, the gases which can form ions in the water, they are more soluble in water. The gases which can dissolve or which can ionize to form ions, they are more soluble in water as compared to any other solvent. Because of this reason only, HCl जो होता है, it is more soluble as compared to oxygen. तब हम बोलते हैं कि water के अंदर जो oxygen का dissolution होता है, वो कम होता है as compared to HCl. Why? Because HCl can dissociate to form H plus and Cl minus ions. Okay, so nature of the solvent पे कैसे depend करेंगी कि जो हमारी जो solvent है, if it is causing the ionization of the gas, then it will be more soluble. And जो gases होती है, they are more ionized in the water as compared to any other solvent. Okay, third point, pressure. That we have to discuss here. How the pressure is affecting the dissolution of gases. See, in the previous case, when we were talking about the solids and liquids, we saw that it doesn't affect. Pressure doesn't affect the solubility of solids in liquids. Why? Because the solids are already, means they are incompressible. You cannot compress them. The molecules are already tightly, closely packed. You cannot compress them. But here, the pressure is going to affect this solubility. It was explained by Henry, and this we will discuss in Henry's law in detail. Okay. The next one, it is the temperature. Temperature, the process of dissolution of this gas in liquids, actually it is exothermic. The process, it is exothermic. So when the temperature increases, जो temperature increase होगा तो क्या होगा? जो gas है उसके अंदर dissolve किया हुआ है, it is expelled out. That means जो solubility है वो हमारी क्या हो रही है? Decrease हो रही है. So we are saying it is an exothermic, and as the temperature increases, the dissolution of gases, it decreases, that is the solubility decreases. So these are the four points which are going to affect this dissolution. Okay, now we will discuss an important law, that is the Henry's law. What does Henry's law relate? The dissolution of gases in liquids, how it is getting affected by pressure. Suppose we are having a system in which we have taken a solution. Okay, this is solution. Now, over this we are having a gas, and we are denoting it by this space. Applied. Okay, W1 amount of weight is pressed to have the pressure on the gas so that the gas is getting dissolved in the solution. Now let's see this system. There are the molecules of gas which are entering inside the solution, and the same number of molecules they are coming out of the solution. So we can say that the system, it is in equilibrium, dynamic equilibrium, where the rate of molecules of gas going into the solution is equal to the molecules of gas which are coming out of the solution. Okay, now what happens if you will increase this pressure? Agar humne pressure increase kar diya, this is the same solution, and now what you are doing, you are increasing the pressure by compressing the gaseous system. हमने और वेट सब दिए तो प्रेशर यहाँ क्या हो गया, बढ़ गया. अभी जो गैशियस सिस्टम है ये क्या होगा, कंप्रेस हो जाएगा, वॉल्यूम इसका कम हो जाएगा. सो what it is causing, the number of gases molecules, jo gas ke molecules hai per unit volume, wo kya ho jayega, badh jayega. First point, the number of molecules of gases per unit volume increases, as well as the molecules of gas which are entering the solution, it will also increase. Okay, so how it had happened, because we had increased the pressure. So hum kya bol rahe, when you increase the pressure, the solubility of gas in the liquid increases. Okay, now it goes into the solution and the solubility increases, and now until a new equilibrium is reached, the solubility will increase and the pressure of the gas above this liquid, it will also increase and it will cause the solubility to increase. So what we are saying, pressure and solubility, इन दोनों के बीच के अंदर जो मैथमेटिकल रिलेशन था, क्वांटिटेटिव रिलेशनशिप था, वो किसने डिफाइन किया था, हेनरी ने. एंड ही गेव अ हेनरीज लॉ एंड ही फाइंड आउट अ क्वांटिटेटिव रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन प्रेशर एंड द सॉलिबिलिटी. व्हाट ही सेड दैट सॉलिबिलिटी ऑफ अ गैस इन अ लिक्विड इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द प्रेशर ऑफ द गैस. अच्छा, अब सॉलिबिलिटी को हम कैसे मेजर करेंगे, इन टर्म्स ऑफ मोल फ्रैक्शन. सो मोल फ्रैक्शन जो है, इट इज अ मेजर फॉर द सॉलिबिलिटी ऑफ गैस इन अ लिक्विड. सो हम इसको कैसे डिफाइन कर सकते हैं, हेनरीज लॉ को, मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ द गैस. मोल फ्रैक्शन से मीनिंग क्या है हमारा, सॉलिबिलिटी. Mole fraction of the gas in a liquid is directly proportional to the pressure of the gas over the solution. Okay, so what we are saying, P is directly proportional to mole fraction of the gas. अगर इस proportionality sign को remove करना है, तो we will write it P is equals to KH mole fraction of the gas. That means जो pressure है, partial pressure of the gas is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the gas which is dissolved into the solution. And to remove this proportionality sign, we are putting a constant that is called as Henry's law constant. Okay, अभी जो Henry's law constant है students, this is a function of the nature of the gas. It is depending only on the nature of the gas. And by the experimental values, it is observed that this KH value, is directly proportional to temperature. अगर आप temperature increase करोगे, तो KH की value भी क्या हो जाएगी, increase हो जाएगी. Fine. अच्छा, अब इस रिलेशनशिप से अगर हम मुझे के एच और मोल फ्रैक्शन रिलेशन निकालना है, तो व्हाट आई विल से, के एच इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ द गैस इन द सॉल्यूशन. दैट मींस जितना ज्यादा के एच की वैल्यू होगी, उतना गैस की सॉल्युबिलिटी कम होगी. ठीक है. अच्छा, अब हम बात करते हैं टेम्परेचर. इफ द टेम्परेचर इज लो, टेम्परेचर लो है, के एच की वैल्यू क्या होगी, लो हो जाएगी. के एच विल बी लो। अच्छा KH लो है तो मोल फ्रैक्शन क्या हो जाएगा, हाई हो जाएगा, सो X विल बी हाई, दैट मींस सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ द गैसेस विल बी हाई इन द गिवन लिक्विड। सो वी कैन से वेरी कॉमन इट इज आस्क्ड व्हाई एक्वेटिक स्पीशीज आर मोर कंफर्टेबल इन कोल्ड वाटर एज कम्पेयर टू वार्म वाटर। सो दिस इज द रीजन वहां पे एक्वेटिक जो स्पीशीज है कंफर्टेबल लो टेम्परेचर पे क्यों है, टेम्परेचर लो है KH विल बी लो, और KH लो है तो सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ द गैसेस विल बी हाई बिकॉज देयर इज मोर अमाउंट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन गैसेस देयर, सो दे आर मोर कंफर्टेबल ओवर देयर। सो हियर वी हैव सीन व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स व्हिच आर अफेक्टिंग द डिसोल्यूशन ऑफ गैस एंड लिक्विड। सेकंड वी डिस्कस अबाउट द हेनरीज लॉ, इट टेल्स अ रिलेशनशिप मैथमेटिकल रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द प्रेशर ऑफ द गैस एंड द सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ द गैस इन द लिक्विड। एंड द थर्ड पार्ट स्टूडेंट्स दैट इज द एप्लीकेशन, आई शुड राइट इट हियर, थर्ड पार्ट इट इज द एप्लीकेशन बिकॉज मोर कॉमनली इट इज आस्क्ड इन द एग्जाम्स व्हाट इज हेनरीज लॉ, एक्सप्लेन इट एंड राइट एनी टू एप्लीकेशन। ओके सो वी विल जस्ट डिस्कस द एप्लीकेशंस। Application it is that in the cold drinks and in the cold drinks and soda water to increase the amount of CO2 in that they are filled with a high pressure. अगर हम cold drinks की बात करें, in cold drinks और soda water कौन सी गैस फिल्ड होती है वहां पे, CO2, एंड वो CO2 का अमाउंट उसके अंदर इंक्रीज करने के लिए क्या किया जाता है, दे आर फिल्ड विद हाई प्रेशर इन कोल्ड ड्रिंक्स एंड सोडा वाटर टू इंक्रीज द अमाउंट ऑफ CO2 फिल्ड विद हाई प्रेशर। अच्छा इसको कैसे रिलेट करोगे, हाई प्रेशर है दैट मींस अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड व्हिच कैन बी डिसॉल्व इनसाइड द लिक्विड इट विल बी हाई। ओके नाउ सेकेंड वन स्कूबा ड्राइवर, ओके स्कूबा ड्राइवर्स दोज हु गो इनसाइड द सी वाटर दे हैव टू कोप अप विद द हाई कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ ऑक्सीजन व्हेन दे आर ब्रीदिंग अंडर द सी वाटर बिकॉज देयर प्रेशर इज वेरी हाई। व्हेन दे गो इनसाइड द प्रेशर इंक्रीजेस अंडर द सी वाटर, इफ द प्रेशर इज हाई दैट मीन्स द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द गैसेज इज ऑल्सो हाई। ओके नाउ एट दैट कॉन्सेंट्रेशन अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ गैसेज गेट डिसॉल्व इन देयर ब्लड। नाउ व्हेन दे कम्स अप द प्रेशर डिक्रीजेज एट द सर्फेस नियर द सर्फेस एंड व्हेन द प्रेशर डिक्रीजेज द गैसेज रिलीजेज एंड व्हेन दीज गैसेज रिलीजेज इन द ब्लड वेसल द बबल्स ऑफ नाइट्रोजन गैसेज आर फॉर्म्ड एंड दीज बबल्स ऑफ नाइट्रोजन दे ब्लॉक द कैपिलरीज and they gives a medical problem that is bends, what we call it as bends, okay, and this is very painful and it is very difficult for them to bear this pain। bends ki jo situation hoti hai usme scuba drivers ko jo hoti hai bahut problem hoti hai and it is very critical to their life also, so to avoid this condition of bends they are advised, these scuba drivers are advised to take their tanks which is filled with the air that is diluted with helium, the tanks which are having the air diluted with helium। now why the helium they are taking the air which is diluted with helium, because the dissolution of helium it is less as compared to nitrogen inside the blood vessels of the scuba drivers। okay the third one at altitudes, altitudes pe kya hota hai वहां पे जो प्रेशर होता है वो क्या होता है, लो। अब जब प्रेशर लो होता है तो जो ऑक्सीजन जो डिसॉल्व होती है इनसाइड द ब्लड दैट इज आल्सो लो, ऑक्सीजन जो बॉडी में जा रही है डिसॉल्व हो रही है दैट इज आल्सो लो, सो इट गिव्स अ लेसर अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी इन द ब्लड सेल्स। सो द पर्संस द क्लाइंबर्स हु आर गोइंग एट आल्टीट्यूड बिकॉज ऑफ द लेस एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर द डिसोल्यूशन ऑफ द ऑक्सीजन इन द ब्लड इट इज वेरी less and they feels tiredness and a condition develops that is called as anoxia in which they find difficulty in breathing and they feel tired, they are not having energy, like that type of feeling occurs, and this condition is called as anoxia. So these are the three applications of Henry's law, and students, along with the theoretical concept, we are also supposed